For lesson three, we get into repetition and selection. And a lot of you are already familiar with this because it's pretty much the same as traditional programming. So in order to do any kind of a repetition or selection, you are going to be using comparison and logical operators. So that's kind of the first thing we review. And there is a video here you can watch that kind of walks through all of that. Then we get into the selection structures in JavaScript, which are pretty much the same as traditional programming. And then we get into repetition structures. And you'll notice that they're fairly similar. While, do, while, for. We have also for in. Okay, and so there are videos for each of those sections as well. And then we talk about the difference between break and continue and when to use each. And then we get into type conversions. This is probably the more confusing area in JavaScript because it's a loosely typed language. So things are never 100% truthful or 100% false. They are truthy or falsy, which is kind of weird. But if you look at this table, it shows you the original values. And then what happens if you convert it to a number and a string or a Boolean? And it's the Boolean column that you probably want to take a look at. So if it starts out as a string and we convert it to a number, it's a zero. A string is still a string. But when you convert it to a Boolean, the value is true, which is kind of weird because normally you would think a zero would be false, right? Because here's a zero and this is false. But because this started as a string, it is true. Okay, same with this one, because it started as a string, it's testing true. Okay, same with this one. Okay, so if it starts as a numeric zero, it's false. So that's a little weird. Here's another one that's weird. If you have nothing, right? So you just, a lot of times we'll initialize a string to nothing. So it kind of wipes out any garbage that was there. If we convert it to a number, it's a zero, okay? And this is testing false. So these are kind of strange things that happen in JavaScript that you just need to be aware of. And then this is also a little unique. So in a logical OR, you can have it look at a couple different things, and if they're both false, you can actually assign a value, and that's all it's saying. But that is unusual. Other languages don't really have that. And so a lot of this chapter is going to be review. There's a couple things that are unique and unusual that you should pay attention to as you're going through it. Then we have a programming assignment. So you'll start by adding folders. There's really no files here for you to copy. In each section, there are some files and graphics that you're going to download. And there's also a video that kind of walks you through making these changes. So you're going to download these, and then you're going to go through. This one is giving you some practice on if-else. Okay, and so the video actually kind of walks through all these instructions so you understand what you're doing. You'll notice we have an if-else in here. We have a regular if. We also have a switch. Then we get into repetition. Again, there's a starter file and a graphic that you're going to download. You're basically going to be looping in this one. So you'll start out creating a loop, and then just so you understand the difference between for, while, and do while, you will take that initial file, save it under a different name, and convert the loop. Okay, so you're going to end up with the same page using a for loop, a version that uses a while loop, and a version that uses a do while loop. Okay, and so this video kind of explains that to you. For this last example, you're going to create a BMI calculator, and there is a similar example to what you need to do in this. And this is just an example of what your finished product should look like. So this is fairly well laid out and explained, and there is this example that you can look at. And if you right click, you view the source, you can see the JavaScript. So you're going to need to do something very similar. So once these are all done, you are going to link them into your assignment page, transfer everything to the web, make sure everything works. This is how you're going to be graded. And then once you're done, you're going to put done in the Dropbox. Next, you are going to go into the Unit 1 quiz. The questions are not just true, false, and multiple choice. They mimic what you're going to see on that MTA. This is open book, open note. There is no time limit, okay? But you only get to take the test once. Okay. Any questions that people have problems with, what I typically do is create extra credit that focuses on those questions because I want you to understand the material that's in the quiz because you may very well see it on your certification exam. So if you run into any problems while you're working through the assignment, please transfer your page and then email me so I can take a look at it. I have a great week, and let me know if you have any questions.